lying flat on the ground, with her forehead touching the earth. The woman and the kid are performing a complete Buddhist prostration. This is a challenge act, especially in Lhasa, Tibet, where the altitude is around 12,000 feet, and the oxygen levels are only 80% of what is available at lower elevations. With deep devotion, many Buddhists like her undertake this act of prostration throughout their journey to Tibet from distant places. Situated in the southwestern part of China on Tibetan Plateau, with an average altitude over 40,000 feet, Tibet, often referred to as the roof of the world, has historically been a revered center for Tibetan Buddhism and its culture. One of the holiest sites in Tibet is Jokhang Temple, a primary destination for pilgrims. Built in the 7th century, this temple houses a statue depicting the Shakyamuni Buddha at the age of 12. This statue holds profound significance for devotees as it is believed to have been blessed by the Buddha himself. For them, encountering this statue is akin to encountering the Buddha in person. The Potala Palace, also located in Lhasa, is another vital destination. It has been listed as the World Cultural Heritage Site since 1994. Majestic and grand, the altar walls of the Potala Palace are crafted using materials of yak milk, white sugar, honey, saffron, and lime. For those who don't follow Buddhism, traveling to Tibet is also a purifying journey in nature. Once stepping onto this soil, you can sense the irresistible power of nature's forces. The beauty of the landscape compels you to surrender. In Tibet, the colors of prayer flags embody the five elements of nature. Blue signifies the sky and immerses a azure crystal above, close enough but forever out of reach. White represents air and wind, a veil concealing the snow mountain goddess, covered in a mysterious charm. Red, like a passionate flame, symbolizes the warmth of fire and the radiance of the sun, while green signifies pure water, akin to an ocean formed from the pooled tears of mermaids. Yellow symbolizes the earth, a land that nourishes us with unparalleled treasures of natural resources, medical herbs, and minerals. Beyond the breathtaking realm of the five element forces, we must also confront the challenges posed by the extreme environment on human body. Many people who come to high altitude regions experience altitude sickness, such as dizziness, difficulty breathing, and even exhaustion after just a few steps.
The altitude here is over 5,000 meters, so we're all heroes here.
The sights and experiences encountered here have a way of pushing people to their limits, both physically and spiritually. Yet, even as nature set its bounds, our inner potential empowers us to transcend them. Here, I also witnessed how the high-speed train seamlessly connects various cities in Tibet, and all those clean and secure roads accomplished by dedicated workers who spent years crafting them. Across the landscape, power stations and signal towers ensure that most areas are blanketed with 4G or even high signals. Surprisingly, even services like Meituan delivery can be found in Tibet, and there are charging stations for electric vehicles. The sacred sites, stunning landscapes, and the challenges inspired a profound connection with nature and self. By surpassing our own limits, we embrace growth and achieve a harmonious life with nature. I'm Xiabing, I will see you next time.